you've ever woke up in a cold sweat nightmare that you had busted a huge garden gnome at a customer's house and the thing came alive and was chasing you around the yard, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Get down in the comment section, drop a comment. Guys, I hope you're having a fantastic week. It is the week after the 4th, Thursday. I am driving a whole bunch this week trying to get parts. Having a real hard time keeping up with parts. Right now, COVID shutdowns are still affecting just the logistics of getting everything in that we need to get. So today's video, we're going to be talking about an OODA loop, O-O-D-A. And you might say, Cody, what is an OODA loop? Well, it's a good question. I'm going to tell you what it is. So my hobby is the firearms world, shooting, training, all that kind of stuff, self-defense stuff. I'm not an expert. I'm not a novice either. I'm probably in the middle. I do take some training classes. I shoot a whole bunch every year, several thousand rounds per year, rifle and pistol. I am proficient, and I do just kind of meddle around in that world. I don't do sports. I don't do nothing else. But in that world, there's a thing called the OODA loop. What that basically is, stands for observe, letter O, orient, another letter O, decide, letter D, and act, letter A, O-O-D-A. So what that's getting at there is, let's have a scenario, okay? And a lot of your training that you can go take, guys, please understand, a concealed carry class to get your concealed carry permit in some of these states that require a class, that's not training, okay? Going to the range and shooting bullseyes, that's not training, that's practice. Training is under instruction. A lot of times those training environments will induce stress. So you guys look up guys like Frank Proctor, Aaron Cowan, Steve Fisher, Sentinel Concepts, major firearms trainers in the country that train at a high level. What they're gonna do is get you out there and get you under stress, and they're gonna role play scenarios which will, you know, translate over more realistically to real life. So let's have a scenario here, okay? And I'm gonna bring this full circle into the business world here at the end. You're at the gas pump, right? You're pumping fuel, and maybe you're talking to your wife, you're talking to somebody at the gas pump that you know, and over here on the side, a unknown is approaching you. Somebody catches your eye out of the corner, and you don't know who that is. And let's say it's a 6'3", big burly guy, possibly a threat, right? Anybody technically is possibly a threat. I mean, little short old lady still could be a threat. But in the moment, you kind of catch a glimpse of movement. What do you have to do? Well, what you've got to do is, number one, you've got to observe it. So you've got to actually see it, right, to know anything is over there. That's why the saying, keep your head on a swivel, that's what that's talking about. You know, be aware of your surroundings. Keep your head on a swivel so that you observe possible threats coming your way. The second thing you have to do is orient, okay? Now that I've seen it, I turn my head, oh, there's a guy. I have to orient my attention, my body posture. Now, I may not move my body. I may just orient my attention so that I see him, and now my attention, my radar has picked up a blip, and I'm looking over that way. Observe, orient. Number three, decide. We've got to decide, what is that? Is that a threat? Is that just a guy walking up for directions? Is it somebody throwing something in the trash can? You know, what's going on here? We got to decide, do we do anything? Is any action needed? And if so, what action? And then number four is act. We act. O-O-D-A, we act. We figure out, what do we got to do? Now, 99.99999999% of the time, we do nothing because it is a nothing scenario, right? That's our daily life. The goal is to live a full, long, peaceful life and never have to do anything. But low probability, high consequences if it ever does happen. That's why you train and you carry your gun and you carry medical, you carry a flashlight, you carry all these things just in case something ever does happen. But with the understanding that probably nothing is ever going to happen. Now, we do this all the time in our daily life. Anytime you're multitasking, you're doing OODA loops processes all day long. You're doing something else gets your attention, you boom, 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 you O-O-D-A through the process very quickly without usually even knowing that you're doing it. Most real life scenarios, like I said, don't matter. You're driving in traffic, somebody cuts you off, and you're the defensive driver, you're doing that all the time. You observe, you orient your attention to it, you you decide, and then you swerve around, you act, and you miss, you know, you avoid a wreck. That's an OODA loop. The better you are at defensive driving, the more easy that scenario is going to play out. My daughter is 18, pretty crappy driver, to be expected. In 10 years, she should be a much better driver, and she should be able to. She makes me nervous when we're driving right now because she can't react to things very quickly like I can. I've been driving for 20 years, so when I, you know, somebody pulls out in front of me, I could still hit them, but I've got a better chance of being able to look ahead and see what's coming. Okay, I'm looking 1,000 yards out, whereas Alyssa's looking 10 feet out. Does that make sense? So that is really the key to winning, is seeing the fight before it happens. Running this OODA loop quickly and efficiently, you boom, 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 boom. What you don't want to have in a fight or a defensive scenario is the bystander effect, where you're just kind of like, time slows down. Whoa, whoa. It's like Call of Duty, like you've been shot, everything slows down. You don't want to have that. You don't want to be kind of stuck in. You ever had those dreams where you're like, you're fighting somebody and you're punching and it feels like your arms just weigh 1,000 pounds and you can't do anything? That will happen to you in real life. The way you get through that and you get past those things happening is you train under stress. It's called stress inoculation. You train for those scenarios so that when and if they come up, you have your unlock codes ready to go and you can run through the scenario. You've won before it even really transpires. In business, how do we bring this around to a business mindset? This year has been a crazy, insane year, okay? Your ability to pivot and to see the fight coming, where's the market? Where's it at? What's going on here? Where's the opportunity? Number one is you've got to observe. You've got to see it. Like, you've got to see what's going on around you. If you're just buried, your head is buried in the sand, and you're just marching forward like always, you can miss the beat and you can be in a world of trouble. Example, Kmart, okay? When I was a kid, Kmart was a big deal. Sears, JCPenney, Toys R Us, these larger companies that have tanked, what did they do wrong? Well, they didn't see the internet coming, okay? They ruled that, they didn't even, their head was in the sand, they're working really hard, right? We're doing all this work, and they're bankrupt, right? Because they did not see the threat to their business, which was their competitor. They didn't see it. They didn't see what was going on around them. So number one, be very aware of your local competition. Be aware of changes in the market. Be aware of what your customers want. Customers' wants and needs change, and you've got to be able to address those and see that crap coming. If you don't see it, you can't do anything about it. Number two, you've got to orient, right? Once you identify the problem, the first step to fix the problem is identifying it, okay? Boom, we've seen it. Step two, let's put some attention on that problem. It doesn't do any good to know there's a problem and you're just not addressing it, okay? We build equipment. We try our dead level best to put out a quality product. It doesn't matter what you do. You're going to have little quality issues, okay? When we identify, hey, there's a problem, we address that problem. We fix it. We put things in place so that we don't continue to have that problem over and over and over again. Most of your guys out there, they're going to be kind of understanding, and hey, if they have a problem, they let me know. We make it right. We move on with life. They're good. We're good. Everything's fine. What you can't do is just keep having the same problem over and over. If you've got a tech out there and he's burning up bushes all the time, okay, there's a problem. You see it. Customers bring it to your attention. Number two, put some attention on that problem. Number three, decide, okay, what do we do about this issue? Whether it's an opportunity that's come up on the horizon, like your radar's picked up an opportunity, or it's a problem that needs to be addressed, whatever it is, you've got to decide, okay? Now, this is usually, number three, the decision process is where people get bogged down. They see it, they know they got to do something about it, they just cannot make up their minds as to what in the world to do about the problem. Decide something, okay? Right, wrong, indifferent, good, bad, just at some point, guys, you got to pick something and do it and see if you get good results. The fear is, I don't want to do something and it not work. You know what's worse than that? Not doing anything. Not doing crap. If your marketing is sucking, okay, you're doing Facebook ads or something like that and you're not getting good returns on it, the worst thing you can do is just do nothing. Run another ad. Run a different style ad. Try. You've got to do something. Maybe that don't. Angie's List. Good example. Next door, Thumbtack. That crap ain't working in Roanoke. I know it's not going to work in Roanoke, but the way I know is I try. Nobody around our town uses that stuff. But in your area, that might be the best thing you could be doing for marketing. So find out what's the problem, orient yourself, you know, analyze it, put some orientation, some energy into it, and then make a decision, and then you've got to act. You've got to actually do it. That might mean spending some money. That might mean, you know, whatever that means, that labor, man hours, a change in your business, the way you do things, your day-to-day. A lot of times I get bogged down in, okay, this is what we do, this is what we do, this is what we do. And week to week, we're okay, but it's not fixing the problem, right? And so I know I'm just going to have to keep repeating this until I stop, orient, observe, orient, decide, and act, and put something in place that's going to change that scenario, and then we can move forward with life. OODA, guys, work on your OODA loops. In real life, you got buku bad guys out there. I mean, it's a crazy year. Some of y'all live in big towns, man. I hope you're packing. There's crazy folks amongst us. You know, I hope everybody's staying safe. You never know. But in business, keep your radar. Keep it spinning. Keep your head on a swivel. Be looking at what's going on in your local market, what you can do to, when you see things on the horizon, orient to them, decide what you need to do to be successful, and then act on it. A good example would be this COVID thing with backpack foggers and stuff. A lot of guys pivoted over and they got into that. They made some really good money. We've got one. We did a job yesterday at the local Christian school. I didn't charge them anything. That's where my kids go to school. We went in and out, zipped it up, got it disinfected. But that's a good example of, you see a change, you address it, you figure it out, decide, and act. Boom. Make money. And if it doesn't work out, you know what? Maybe the backpack blower sits over there in the corner and collects dust, right? But it's a small investment, and it might have a chance to salvage a year. You know, this has just been a crazy year, so there's been a lot of opportunities for learning these lessons. Hope you guys have a fantastic week. Let's get on down the road here and get what we need to get and get back home. We will check in with you tomorrow. Got some equipment headed out tomorrow and some training. We're going in the right direction. it's chaos. Hired a new guy. He'll be starting with us Monday, working in the shop assembly. Very mechanically savvy guy. He's a friend. He was a very accomplished maintenance guy. So this is going to be a cakewalk for him, but it's going to help us out a whole lot in the shop. So we'll introduce you guys to him next week sometime. Hope you guys have a fantastic week. We'll check in with you later. See ya.